10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2.
Hello, welcome to the 57th episode of the Magnolia Clubhouse Weekly Report. I'm Ryan.
And I'm Ron. We are your hosts for this episode, which covers Monday, August 9th through Friday, August 13th. Are you superstitious, Ryan?
No, Ron. Why do you ask?
Because it's Friday the 13th, which is a day of bad luck.
Well, Ron, thank God I'm not superstitious then. Instead, I believe we're going to have to not just have a great day, but have a full great week all this week.
Well, amen to that, Ryan. We'll start with our report with what is going on the membership unit.
Good afternoon, everyone. I hope everyone is doing well. Happy second week of August. My name is TJ, and I'm here for today's edition of our weekly unit update. Boom! In celebration of National Book Lovers Day, let's reflect on the books we love reading. What about history, geography, love story, physics, or whatever you'd like? Let's celebrate the words, text, and meaning that continue to shape our mind. Plus, the membership unit would like to recognize our particular staff. A Leo at heart, Mr. No-Nonsense, and die-hard problem solver, happy belated birthday to our very own John Fisher. Unit work continues to happen on our floor daily. If you're up with meeting new people, learning to do tours and orientation, or providing support to employment or education, please come join our unit. Scholarship will be put on hold until we move to phase two of the program. If you have questions, Nikki is available. The employment and education meeting happens weekly every Tuesday at 2 p.m. on membership unit. We're encouraging members interested to join us, if you'd like, support with either program. Thank you to all the members who contributed their time and effort to keep the unit work moving forward. Remember, your work impacts our operation and our community.
Thank you, membership unit. You guys are doing a great job.
Ryan, I wonder what's going on the hospitality unit. Did they burn something again?
Yeah, me too. Here's Aaron with the menu for this week. Aaron, take it away.
Hey guys, it's Aaron from the hospitality unit with this week's report. The cafe should be opening soon, so stay tuned. And this week's menu is: on Monday we're having sloppy joes with Jojo's. On Tuesday, turkey meatballs with side salads. On Wednesday, turkey or tofu green bowls. On Thursday, BLT with coleslaw. And Friday, chicken parm with homemade bread. Thanks.
Now, here's me with what you can expect from this week's weather. On Monday, August 9th, the day you'll be looking at this, it will be partly cloudy with a high of 90 and a low of 76. And that'll be the trend for the week. Tuesday, we're looking at scattered thunderstorms with a high of 89 and a low of 76. Wednesday, we're looking at partly cloudy skies with scattered thunderstorms with a high of 86 and a low of 73. On Thursday, we're looking at variable clouds with thunderstorms and an expected high of 84 and a low of 72. Friday the 13th. It's a special occasion, you know. We don't have that many Friday the 13th this year. Count your blessings. Expect thunderstorms with a high of 83 and a low of 70. And this weekend, you can expect rain with partly cloudy skies and a high of 80 and a low of 69. And finally, on Sunday, August 15th, you can expect it to be partly cloudy with a high of 81 and a low of 68.
Tales from the Crypt.
Nature's always changing. The
oh, hello, Crypt.
Back to more news at one.
Thanks. Next, Ron, it's time for the administration unit report. Here's Renee and Nick to tell us more about what goes on the Magnolia Clubhouse shop.
You know, I've been to the shop a lot, and I've also worked in the shop. It's a great unit to work on. Nick is always looking for help, so keep that in mind, everybody.
My name is Renee, and I am a Magnolia Clubhouse member. We have lots of loyal customers that come in, and we encourage them to take their time and browse. And we also like to help them when they purchase things to carry them to the car. We don't like to wait for them to ask. Also, people that donate things, we want to go and bring the donations into the shop before they ask us. Also, down in the basement, we have a room that's designated for members, and a lot of the things that aren't sellable inside the shop, we designated for members, and they're free, they're household goods. So if you ever need things in your home, please come and visit the shop and come down to the basement and have a great treasure.
Thank you, Renee. And yeah, it's important for everybody to remember that as a member, you always, always, always get 50% off of whatever you see in the shop and free delivery if it's a large furniture item.
Also, we try to promote giving out our business cards because a lot of people can't always come to the shop, and the business cards have our numbers on it, which gives them the ability to call when they want to donate things or when they want to find out what we have in the shop. So if you do work within the shop, be aware that we have brochures which tells about Magnolia House and what our efforts are, what we're all about, and our business cards have our members.
Thanks for that update, guys. That's fantastic information to know about the shop. You know, there are always great deals over in the shop, and you can also buy member t-shirts at the shop for $12.
Yeah, Ron, I didn't know the shop had a special area in the basement just for members. I'll have to check that out.
Yeah, Ryan, I'll have to check that out for sure. I've been down there before. Well, let's go to Willie, our man with all the moves, for a spot discussing yoga and yoga moves. Willie, take it away.
Hello, Clubhouse. I was sitting here contemplating on what yoga pose of the week should I do. But guess what? Our new staff, Erin.
Hi.
Maybe we could do the ninja pose. Here's me and Ron to give you all a demonstration of the ninja pose. First, stand straight up. Put your arms to the side. Breathe in. Breathe out. Turn your left foot and your right foot outwards towards the wall. Bend your knees and bend down some. Take your arms, lift them straight up in the air, inwards. Breathe in. When you breathe out, bring your arms down and tuck them. Well, came in it, so might as well go out. Arms back up. Stand straight up. Arms down to your side. Feet stand straight.
Thanks, Willie, for that report. Now I can get my yoga moves on.
Although some of us don't bend or twist, I mean, we can work on it. Up next is Megan with some very important information about emotional support animals.
Hi, my name is Megan. I'm a dog groomer and pet caregiver. I'd like to talk to you for a moment about emotional support animals. An emotional support animal, or ESA, which is a type of animal that provides comfort to help relieve a symptom or an effect of a person's disability. An emotional support animal is not a pet and is generally not restricted by species. An emotional support animal differs from a service animal. Service animals are trained for up to 2 years and have to be able to pass public access tests. And it's trained to do tasks that assist disabled people. The benefits of emotional support are easing worrying to be able to pass public access tests. And it's trained to do tasks that assist disabled people. The benefits of emotional support are easing worrying, providing comfort, reducing the sense of isolation and loneliness. In order to get the benefits of an emotional support animal, you would need a prescription letter from a mental health professional. Talk to Dave or staff for more information. After you obtain the prescription letter under Head Rules, you can get all your pet fees waived and have your emotional support animal and rental properties and not forget animals. You do not need to pay online fees. Any attempt to get to pay should be considered a scam. They do not have public access. They are not allowed in Walmart or other public places. Animals are not permitted. However, you can train your emotional support animal into becoming a service animal if it's a dog with a good temperament, with the guidance of a trainer, or if you're good at it, training yourself. There's lots of books and YouTube videos to help. Again, my name is Megan. If you have any more questions about pet care, feel free to ask me. Thanks for listening. Take care.
It's now time for our weekly sports report with our very own Scott Trulla, the man that's done over 200 podcasts, and Keith in Lakewood.
Hello, everyone, and welcome once again to another edition of Magnolia Clubhouse Sports. He's Scott Trulla, I'm Keith in Lakewood. Let's get started. Cavs made a trade to get 10-year point guard veteran Ricky Rubio and extended center Jared Allen a 4-year extension worth a reported $100 million. Scott, with all the wheeling and dealing that's been going on with the Cavs, how does it shape for the team and looking forward for this coming season?
Well, these are some interesting signings, and a lot of questions, but there's some media that feels that I might have been a mistake, but we don't know until we see them play.
Speaking of extensions, we're moving on to the Cleveland Browns, where veteran running back Nick Chubb received a 3-year extension worth a reported $12 million. Scott, this was one of the first of the key personnel that the Browns needed to sign in order to keep the team intact. Is Baker Mayfield next on the list?
I do believe he is next on the list, and it very well could be, because I don't think that the Browns are not going to want to lose him. He's been a great quarterback, and he's the quarterback that the Browns need. And so I think Nick Chubb's going to be around for a while, and I think Baker Mayfield will be around for a while. And this will be day 8 of training camp today in Berea.
Well, Scott, that is it for this edition of Magnolia Clubhouse Sports Report. That is the final buzzer. I'm KIL. It's all yours.
And you know my famous words. Always remember, be a team player each and every day in every way possible. So long, everybody. 3, 2, 1. We're done.
In other news, here is myself with this week's standard number 19.
Well, look at you. So industrious.
Hi, I'm Ryan, and this is this week's standard number 19. All work in the clubhouse is designed to help members regain self-worth, purpose, and confidence. It is not intended to be job-specific training.
And finally, it's time for Willie to give us our quote of the day. Take it away, Willie.
Hello, everyone. This is the quote of the day. It goes like this. Don't start your day with the broken pieces of yesterday. Anonymous.
That, unfortunately, my friends, that's all for this week. The communications unit, which this report is recorded on, which produces this news program, would like to thank all our contributors and encourages you to come up and join us if you are interested in participating. Be sure to check out Magnolia Clubhouse's Facebook page as well as our YouTube channel.
If you enjoyed what you've seen this week, then be sure to like this video and consider subscribing to our YouTube channel.
MagnoliaClubhouse.org is our official website, and we maintain a presence on Twitter, Instagram, and Facebook. I, of course, have been Ron.
And I'm Ryan.
Thanks for watching, and we'll see you all next week. Live long and prosper.
Bye.